talk about the superstitions and ghosts. You believe in ghosts, James?
I've been around here enough to think that there's something going on.
Okay. I think a lot of it does have to do with, you know, your belief. I mean, if you're open to it, I think the door might open. And I think if you're close to it, I think the door kind of might stay closed, mm-hmm. right?
Absolutely.
So, I mean, I'm open to it. I mean, my story is when we went and shot Virginia City, right? I was there to shoot it. I wasn't there to really debate whether there were ghosts. I was there to document, right? And when I was in that Washaw Club, and I'm by myself in that building, and that hand went like that, and I went just like I would if you were doing it, right? I mean, I turned around, and I was so shocked when there was nobody there, right? No one. And that changed my whole philosophy on what I thought about ghosts. So I do think you got to be open, right? Do you agree? Or?
Absolutely. I think if you're out here, you gotta keep an open mind to that stuff because things happen and there's really no explanations for them.
You know, the show is myth, legends, and lies, right? So we're talking about the ghost. I saw a video the other day of a guy that said he was a tracker and he was a packer and he would bring people in. He was a guide, right? And he said he wouldn't come out here at night. And he said he wouldn't come out. I saw a video of a guy. It's got a lot of hits too, like 825,000, right? And he's out here pretty close to where we're at. And he's talking about he wouldn't come out here at night because, you know, he's talking about the fact that there, you know, there's ghosts and demons. And so what we do is we break it down into three parts, right? That's why the show is myths, legends, and lies, right? Because before I just say it's haunted or it's not haunted, what's history tell us, right?
Right.
You know,
there's all the stories. Right, and you gotta follow those to.
You gotta find out where it goes to.
Right.
So, the funny thing is, it's not like most things. Actually, the history, if you believe the history, then you almost gotta believe this haunted, right? Because the Indians called this the home of the thunder gods, right? For years, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. You know, there's Indian ruins all throughout the Superstition Mountains, right? And they all believed it was haunted, all of them, right? And they lived in it. This wasn't some guy coming in on an occasion, right? These are people that actually spent their lives on this very soil, right?
And those stories go back to when they first started settling here.
On and on and on, right? And you know, one of the people that I've become like more respectful of anybody anymore is the Spanish. You know, coming here in the 1500s, just getting to the United States or Mexico, the travel, the unbelievable, you know, the perils that they had to go through just to get here before they even started, right? So the Spaniards come here looking for the seven cities of Cibola, right? And what do? They're the ones that nicknamed this superstitions because they believed it was totally evil. So here's the next group of people that come in that aren't from here, right?
And immediately jump to there's something going on.
Yeah. So the first people that's lived here 1,000 years, right? They believe it's haunted. Another group of people from another continent, another world, another place, has never been here. They come in, and what's the first thing they do? They're the ones that said that this is the Superstition Mountains. They're the ones that named this was the Spanish. And they're saying that there's something going on here, right? And so, I mean, I wouldn't be afraid to walk out here. I mean, we document stuff. I mean, if I believe it's out here, I have to come out here at night. It ain't that I wouldn't, it's I have to. I owe it to everybody out there to be able to see what the truth is. We're gonna do that. We're gonna come out here at night and we're gonna see what really is. Now, James has done the Arizona Trail, okay? He's packed that, traveled 800 something miles, you know, throughout the deserts and the highlands of Arizona. He's packed by himself. You've been tracked by what? Mountain lions.
Mountain lions.
Yeah, fun stuff, right?
Oh yeah.
So, I mean, he's traveled this very very country by himself, right? I mean, we were up near Rogers Trough.
Yeah.
We were up there. That's where the Arizona Trail does go through some of the superstitions. Is that correct?
That's correct. Yeah.
Okay. And so, I mean, it's not that we wouldn't, yeah, I'll come out here. But do I think something's going on? Okay, so let's talk about that. So what do we think about, do you think it's haunted, right? So do you think it's haunted?
Yeah, I don't know. You know, there is enough stories and enough, you know, throughout history, even to modern times, stuff happening out here that you have to believe there's at least some kind of spiritual curse going on. Because between, you know, all the modern travelers, the amount of guys that have just died out here doing normal things, just hiking, you know, it makes you wonder.
Well, you know, we haven't even really got it. We talked about the Spanish. We talked about the Indians, right? The original Indians. They thought it was haunted. We thought about the. Then we go to the Spaniards, right? Mm-hmm. Who come in and they nickname it Superstitions because it's haunted, right? That's what they say. And then we talk to more the more modern, mm-hmm. right? Explorer out here. You know, over 60 people have died out here. You know, in the more modern era, you used to say. You know what, 1850s on, mm-hmm. and I mean, there's something going on out here. I don't know what it is. I'm not going to tell you. I will tell you this. When I have hiked out here, I mean, you look around you today, this is the most beautiful place that ever was. But there's something to it, not just the beauty of it that lures you in, but there's something here I always, and maybe it's just me because I'm open to it, when you're hiking over in these canyons, and man, you don't feel like you're by yourself, you know?
No, there's an energy in these mountains.
And so I don't know if you could call that energy, you know, the ghost, right? But it definitely is, you definitely feel like you're not alone. I mean, I could say that for sure. And then the amount of people that's been killed out here, if that has anything to do with. And, you know, here we haven't even talked about, you know, there's so many things you can talk about when you do the research, right? And the research is the most important thing. And you look at the amount of Indians that's been massacred out here. The amount of settlers that's been massacred out here, the amount of people that's been killed out here. I mean, it's unbelievable the amount of death and destruction that's blood's been spilled on this land.
I mean, near this very spot, Peralta's.
The Peralta Massacre is just right across this peak over here, and that's where a lot of the Lost Dutchman lore lays in the fact that. The Peraltas came up here before, they knew, here's the story. The Peraltas knew that the United States was going to take this ground back. They wanted to come in one more time and get as much gold out of this area as they possibly could. And maybe they were over at Goldfield. We're not saying they were up here. They could have been tracking back home that way. The trail could have went that way, right? Mm-hmm. And then the Apaches got them. And we know how brutal the Apaches were, because so could that be possible? Absolutely, it could be possible. I think we all agree on that, right? Mm-hmm. The Apache definitely could have. So the Apache attacked the mule train filled with ore, right? The Apaches had no desire to pick the gold up. They wanted the mules, but they didn't pick the gold up, right? Because to them it was just rocks, right? And so they left it. And one of the myths is the Dutchman found one of those bags of that gold, you know, less than a mile from here, right? And so that's one of the legends. But that massacre supposedly happened right over that hill. And so is this area haunted? You know, there's something here. You know, I believe, and we're on this journey going around the superstitions, because most people realize that there's no gold within the inner part of the mountains. But on the outside loop of the superstitions is rich, precious metals, right? Whether it be silver or gold, all the way around,
copper,
right?
Yeah.
Because globe, all those places was where they found precious metals. Now, my belief is, and I saw this in one of the caves, right? Is that there's a circle pattern that you see. Now, that means a lot of different things to a lot of cultures, but what I believe in this area, what it means is that the gold's on the outside. And that the energy is on the middle, but the gold, which pushed the gold and the precious metals out, is what I believe. And so you go around the circle of the superstitions, and there's gold, and there's silver, huge silver and gold mines, huge. I mean, this is documented and done. So, what is the curse? And you know, that's something else. Is it a ghost or is it a curse?
I lean on the curse, just based on all the different different experiences, all the research you can do, all the different stories.
I mean, it's a fabulous place and a fabulous journey. And you know, that's what that's part of the lore of this place too, is the curse, is the ghost, is the gold, is the myth, legend, or the lie, right? And it's there might be a lie to the fact of the actual Dutchman's gold, but there's not a lie that there was a Dutchman. There's not a lie that this action went on. It's not a lie that there was gold found right over here at Goldfield, all within this 2.5-3 mile loop that we're on right now. And it's a fascinating story. When I go to Superstition, when did you go to Superstitions at night? You've been there.